Blessings, everybody. How is everybody doing tonight? Everybody mute. How y'all doing tonight? Bless the Lord. Jesus is real and good. It's so good to be here again tonight. Amen. I believe there's going to be a whole nother move of God here tonight. I'm excited about the power of a godly man. Amen. It's awesome, awesome, awesome. Y'all, if you're doing good, just can you throw a thing up for me? Amen. Amen. I'm just so excited about seeing everybody here tonight. I want to welcome everybody all over the world. Amen. Everybody that's doing Facebook Live, everybody from every country that's on tonight, all of you that's on Zoom, we'd like to welcome you to our annual, amen, the Power of a Godly Man Summit. I'm so glad to be here. Me, along with the Kingdom Dominion Assembly family, we welcome you. And we want you to have a great time. And we believe God is going to pour out some more oil tonight. We had an awesome time last night with Pastor Derek Cole. Amen. Our musical guest, Minister TJ Fails. Amen. Tonight, we have some more great guests. And we just thank God for everybody tonight. And from all of you that's in Kenya, Africa, and Nigeria, we thank you for tuning in tonight again, and we just going to have good time, and I love you all, and we just going to rock, amen. All of my Facebook friends, thank you for tuning in. All of my Real Talk with Dr. Baker friends, thank you for tuning in. We're just going to have a great time tonight, amen. We're going to go to our prayer with our own Pastor Snow. Amen. He's going to pray for us right quickly. Amen. Y'all come on and thank God for him. With a thumbs up. Keep muted. Amen. Let's do this.
Amen. Father, we thank you tonight. God, we bless you. God, we give you glory. God, we reverence you. God, we thank you. God, we thank you for pouring your spirit out upon our flesh. God, we ask you to come in tonight and fill this Zoom. In other words, fill the rooms, each and every room, God, that we are assembled tonight, God, to receive from you, God. Fill the rooms on tonight, God. Let your fresh anointing move through the atmosphere in the name of Jesus, that yokes be destroyed in the name of Jesus. We bind everything that's not like God. We come against every cunning, crafty word, every bite spirit, everything that's not of God. We come against it now. We cancel the assignment of the enemy. God, we thank you now for your power and your dominion, God. God, move by your power, move by your authority. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. I'm so glad that we live streaming. Thank you, Pastor Snow. And, you know, before we go any further, I always believe that we should have a hot testimony. Amen. We got to have just one. I see both of my guests are here tonight. I am excited to have Elder Clyde Douglas going to sing for us tonight. Amen, a powerful man of God. Amen. And then we're going to have our speaker. I see him all the way from the great state of Texas. Hallelujah. Amen. We rocking right now, right? Amen. So I want to have me one good hot testimony from one of these great, awesome men of God. And I think tonight I want to get Pastor Rico, let's have you testify quickly.
Blessing, blessing, blessing. I just want to thank God for life, health, and strength. Thank God for what he's doing in my life. I thank God for you, Apostle. I thank God for the revival. I just thank God for him, who he is in my life, and the things that he's doing, how God is blessing, how God is moving. I'm just excited. I'm excited for tonight. I'm excited for everything he's doing in my life and yours. Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's awesome. 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 Everybody, could you just put your hands together and give God some praise right where you are? Just give him some praise right where you are, please. Amen. Y'all stop acting all deep tonight. Amen. Y'all acting deep. Ooh, Lord have mercy. Give God some praise. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We just thank God tonight. And we're going on. We're not waiting. We're not rushing. We're just giving God praise. I'm so excited. Hallelujah. But I just want to take out a moment and y'all just give God some praise, okay? Could y'all just give God some praise where you are? Amen. Now, we live streaming. We everywhere. Amen. Give God some praise right where you are, okay? And you don't have to have your, just stay muted and praise him right where you are, okay? Amen. Hallelujah. We thank God for everybody from everywhere. God is so good. Elder Clyde, you ready to sing for me? I know you are.
God bless you, ma'am.
God bless you. I'm so glad you're here tonight. Is that all the way from Orlando?
Lake City, Florida.
Lake City. All right, yeah. Lake City, Florida. God is so awesome, right? They pushed us all in the house, and then what we did, we just came together and took and keep taking this movement flowing, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Ooh, bless the Lord. I just thank God. It's just so amazing. I'm excited. And I'm just excited. And I want everybody to be excited. I thank God for the men of vision that's on here tonight. Y'all throw up a hand. Come on, the men of vision. Can we have a thumbs up for all y'all? Okay. Amen. Amen. Listen, we're going to go right on in with Elder Clyde is going to be our musical guest tonight. And let God use you, man of God. Let's rock. Come on and do what God called you to do. Amen.
Bless you. Praise the Lord, everybody that's tuning in. How many know that in times like this, we simply need the Lord on tonight? Every moment, every second, every minute, and every hour, we need the Lord. Hallelujah.
Come on, right
where you are. Just create an atmosphere of worship. Create an atmosphere of praise in your space and allow God to permeate the very atmosphere of your home, your car, your office, wherever you're zooming in from. Hallelujah. I need you like the ocean needs the water, or it will run dry. Oh, I need you like the stars above, need the setting of the sky. I need you like tomorrow needs the hours of today to pass by. Lord, I need you more and more, so please hear my humble cry. Oh Lord, I need the
now, my Savior, my Savior.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Here we are, God. Here we are, Father. Here we are, Father, anticipating your move, anticipating your glory, anticipating Shekinah. Here we are, Father. We're gathered here today, God, anticipating an outpour, God, of another wave of glory, God. We need you, Father, every moment, every minute, every second, every hour, God, like never before.
Jesus.
Bless your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Father. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We come to thee. Come on and thank God for our summons tonight. Amen. Our musician of tonight. Amen. Elder Clyde Douglas. Woo. He'll be with us again tomorrow night. We give God so much praise for him being here tonight. Elder, could you hit that again for me? Just a little more. Just a little more.
Hallelujah. Absolutely. Hallelujah. Come on, stay right there. Stay right there. Don't you stop worshiping. Don't you stop praising, because the God that we serve, he's so marvelous. He's so worthy of everything that we have. I don't know how your day has gone. I don't know what battles you have faced, but we've come to bring the sacrifice of praise. We've come to pour our praise at the Father like the oil from the alabaster box. Come on, Zion. Come on, men of valor. Come on, mighty men. Come on, brothers and sisters. Come on, Zion, and open yourselves up to the Father as we declare his glory, as we declare his worship, as we declare his praise.
Yes.
And come. Here I am, Lord. I come. I may not have much, but everything I have, it belongs to you. And I pour my praise on you. I come. I come. Oh, I come to thee.
Jesus.
Ooh, ooh. Oh,
thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, I come. I come. I come to thee. Some of you may have to come in on broken pieces tonight, but however you have to do, get into the presence of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, 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 I come to thee.
Hallelujah.
Somebody lift your hands right there and just signal the Father and say, here I am, Lord. Whatever you need him to be, he is the great and mighty I am. Here I am, Lord. He's Alpha and Omega. He is the author and the finisher. He's the great and mighty I am. He's the lion and he is the lamb. He's ruler and redeemer. Oh, Holy One, Ancient of Days. We bless your name, oh Lord. We bless your name, oh Lord. We bless your name, oh God. We bless your name, oh Lord. bless your name.
Hallelujah.
Oh, oh,
thank you, Jesus.
Oh, oh, Father.
No, no, no.
Oh, yes, Father.
Yes, 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 yes.
We cry holy to your name.
Holy, holy.
We cry holy to
Hallelujah.
Your name. We cry holy to your name.
Thank you.
Oh, sweet wonder, lover of our soul.
Thank you, Jesus.
Alpha, oh, we cry holy to your name.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
We cry holy to your name, Lord. Your name is wonderful. Your name is sweet. I know.
Yes.
And we cry holy to your name.
Hallelujah.
For we come.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Oh, my, my, my.
Hallelujah.
We come.
Yes, God, I thank you.
Oh,
yes, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes,
we come. Yes, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We come.
You, Jesus.
We come to thee.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
Jesus.
Yes, 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 yes.
There's just something
Woo.
About
yes.
that
man. Hallelujah.
Some may call him Master,
Woo.
Savior.
Yes.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He's just like a fragrance after the rain.
Yes, 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 yes.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yes, hallelujah.
Jesus.
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 Hey.
Let all heaven
hallelujah.
And earth proclaim. Kings and kingdoms,
yes.
they shall all pass away. But there's something,
yes.
But there's something,
something.
But
hallelujah.
There's something
hallelujah.
About
the name of Jesus.
Name.
Yes.
Ah. There's something about that name.
Yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Oh, my, 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 my.
Yes. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Glory to the Lamb of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
There's something about the name of Jesus. Oh, God, I thank you. If you could just lift your hands and begin to worship the Lord. There's something about the name of Jesus that causes things to shake. Hallelujah. There's something about the name of Jesus that we have to reverence it and give him worship. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we not just having another service, but we giving it all up to Jesus. And it's something about when we come together in unity, hallelujah, that there is an outpour of his spirit. And he began to move in such a way when we honor him in our presence. Come on, somebody, and just begin to worship Jesus. There's something about the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This atmosphere is conducive for worship. We believe in God for so much tonight. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to keep going in a minute, but we just got to give God some worship right there. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. I give God the praise and I lift up Jesus because the enemy thought he had shut us down. Hallelujah. But he made us, we got stronger. In the midst of the pandemic, we got strong. Come on, somebody. We got stronger. Hallelujah. We got wiser and greater. Woo. My, 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 my. We had to grow up. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God expanded our mind, hallelujah, with wealth of knowledge. Can't nothing hold us down because we got Jesus. We got Jesus. Hallelujah. To him be glorified. I'm just excited. Bless the Lamb of God. I am excited tonight. Amen. Y'all come on and thank God for Elder Clyde Douglas. Amen. Powerful. I call it songs, praise and worship, just all of it. Amen. Usher us in. Y'all excited? Let me see with your thumbs. You excited? Woo! All of y'all on Facebook Live, y'all excited? I am excited. We live streaming. Look, we just doing it like God wanted to be done. Amen. I'm just excited. Thank you. Thank you, Elder. Thank you so much. Amen. Whew, hallelujah. We're getting ready for our speaker tonight. Amen. I'm going to read some of his bio, some of it. I had him to give me a little short, just a little short something. Amen. He bigger than his bio, but you know, since I know him and y'all don't know him, I told him to go on and give me a little something. Amen. Let me read it to y'all. Okay. Overseer Larry D. Watts is a dynamic teacher that God has utilized for today's unparalleled times. Overseer Larry's vision is to allow God to raise up an army of men that would be pillars in church, but also in their communities. His goal is to provoke men, husbands, brothers, and young men of vision to recognize their divine inner strength and power that they possess within God. Overseer Larry retired from the U.S. Marine Corps, and he currently serves alongside his wife, Apostle Ty Watts, as pastor of the Remnant Family Worship Center in Houston, Texas, where together they are gathering a remnant of people that desire to be fruitful and increase in God. Overseer Larry has been married to Apostle Ty Watts for over 30 years, and together they have three sons. This is a man that God has tailor-made to impact and empower this nation and the nations. Amen, and the nations. So I got my little bit I added, Pastor Larry. Mm-hmm. And my little bit is I met him and his wife many years ago, him and Apostle Ty, his wife many years ago, and they taught me how to do live television, which is so instrumental in my life right now. I learned it right at their church, how to do live television. Hallelujah. And I just thank God for Pastor Larry tonight and Apostle Ty. Amen. I don't know, is she on Pastor Larry?
She's not, I don't see her on yet.
Okay. I'm going to have her to shout out at y'all. Amen. Some of y'all remember Pastor Ty, but this is a great man of God here. Pastor Larry and I, we just laugh when I'm in Texas. I love Texas. I love Houston and I love Dallas. Amen. I wish I could stay in both of them at the same time, but live in Florida. Mm-hmm. Amen. I thank God for him being here tonight. And I believe that God has a word for him, with for us through him. Y'all come on and give him a great big hallelujah blessing. Thank you. Come on through here, Pastor Larry. Come on and let us have what God got for us tonight.
Amen, 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 amen. Thank you. Hey, come on. Let's give God a hand. Come on.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
We got to listen. Every opportunity we get, we got to praise him. We got to thank him. Amen. Because we didn't have to be here right now. God sustained us, and we owe him a praise. We owe him a worship. Amen. And first of all, let me get the preliminaries out of the way. Because first of all, I am thankful for your apostle, Carol Baker. Amen. For allowing me to do, it's an honor to speak into the lives of men. It's an honor to speak into the lives of men, because we have so much purpose and destiny. And then I want to preach my message too soon, but there's so much entitled into the man's life. So I thank you, and I want to give thanks to the Kingdom Dominion Assembly. Thank you for having me. And I bring greetings all the way from Houston, Texas, from the one of the greatest churches on this side of heaven, the Remnant Family Worship Center. And then in bio, I pastor with my wife, Apostle Ty Watts. So, amen. So I'm looking forward to blessing, speaking what thus says the Lord. Amen. 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 I know you guys had a fantastic service yesterday with Pastor Derek Cole. It was a blessing. Amen. So let's get right into it. If you will, grab your Bibles. Let's go to 1 Timothy 6, chapter 6, verses 6. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 6. And one of the things as we talk on tonight, our theme is the power of a godly man. The power of a godly man. And we got to recognize how essential it is for us as godly men to be the focal point, to be vocal, to be present, and to be aware of our times, but also of our atmosphere. And one of the things that I always say, we have the ability to shift our atmosphere. You have the ability to shift your atmosphere. If it's not conducive, begin to speak into it. Amen?
Amen.
So we're going to go 1 Timothy chapter 6, verses 6 to 12. If you have it, you'll find these words resting there. It says, but godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into the world, and it's certain we can carry nothing out. And having food and raiment, let us be therewith content. And verse 9 says, but they that will be rich fall into temptations and a snare or traps and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in their destructions. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith. That's key. They have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. But thou, O man of God, flee these things. Follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, and meekness. And verse 12, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, and whereunto thou art also called and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. I'm going to take my scripture from verse 11. But thou, O man of God, flee these things and follow after righteousness, godliness, and faith and love. I know our theme is the power of a godly man. If I had to, I would subtitle this message, it's time to fight. It's time to fight. Hallelujah. Amen. Listen, as I've spoken before, it is an honor to speak into men, because men has a great responsibility. And I know in this in society today, they try to downplay the role of a man. And in all actuality, we are under attack. We are under attack by the police. We are under attack for our purpose. We are under attack in our families. We are under attack in who we are. But we cannot allow those things to derive us from what God has called us to be. Amen? Amen. We have to make sure that we stay focused and we stay present and we stay connected to God. And we do not allow anyone to shake us from the horns of the altar, shake us from the connection of God.
Yes.
And one of the things is, why is it so we are so much on attack? I know we have women on the line. I'm not downplaying women.
We understand, Pastor. Go on, do you.
I just want to make sure.
Pastor, we understand. You the speaker.
But we got to understand that the men, listen, the men is the head of the household. The men drive. Yes. The men it should be the focus. Woo. Amen. One of the things you have to understand, and I was in service, one of the things I always learned, even in battle, you always go for the head. Because once you cut off the head, then you cut off the communication, you cut off the flow. And so that's why men is so under attack. And one of the things we have to understand, before we was ever born, before we was ever, our mother and daddy ever met each other, hit that first milkshake and hit that first kiss, we had a promise. God has given us a promise. He gave us a covenant. And what was that covenant? I can't have a men's conference without doing the legwork. I know Pastor went over this yesterday, but I got to do the legwork. Amen. If you will, go to Genesis 1, 26, and we're going to go to verse 26 through 28, and I'm going to move quickly through these. And we find out, why are we under attack? And God said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness. That alone is the reason why we have a bounty on our head. Because we are in the image of God. We are in the likeness of God. We should walk in his characteristics. Amen? And he says, and let them have dominion over the fish, over the sea, over the fowl, over the air, and all the earth, and every creeping thing that creepeth on the earth. And then he says, in 27, he says, so God created man in his own image, in the image of God created he him, male and female, created he them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. One of the things we have to understand, what is the power of a godly man? It was already, we was born into it. Once you become obedient, once you become a sub-God in your heart, this is what God has given you. Since we are made in his image and his likeness, he gave us his attributes. And what was those attributes he given us? He have commanded and he have given us authority and power on day one. Day one, this is what you have. He have made a covenant before you came. Listen, you are inheriting to it. And the Bible says, what was the covenant? What did you inherit? What is so important about you as a man that you got a bounty on your head? What are the things that they don't want you to operate in? And when I say they, I'm talking about the enemy. We're not talking about flesh and blood. We're talking about principalities right now. And it says, one, be fruitful. Two, multiply. Three, replenish. Four, subdue. And most of all, five, have dominion. One of the things we have to understand is those five things are very essential to us as men. And as we go through life, and, you know, and we have some hiccups in life and so forth, we cannot allow our emotions, we can't allow society to take us from the power that we have, that God has given us. We must be fruitful, multiply, replenish, subdue, and have dominion. Let me just break that down just for a moment, if you don't mind. When God is saying, be fruitful, what he's saying is produce with good results. Be beneficial. Be profitable. And most of all, be useful. God wants you to be productive in society. He wants you to be productive. And not only do he want you to be productive in the kingdom, but he wants you to be productive in society. Multiply. When he's saying multiply, what he's saying is to accumulate. Build up. Watch this. And that is key. That we have to build each other up. We have to make sure that we pour into our own brethren. We have to build up. But not only, he says, you got to enlarge, expand, and be fertile. Three, replenish. When he's talking about replenish, he's talking about restore, refresh, and provide. Restore, refresh, and provide. We have to make sure that when one of us get off, we have the ability. Just point at yourself that I have the ability to restore my brethren. I have the ability to restore my sister. I have the ability to pick them up. Amen? And four, subdue. Subdue, what he's saying is, I have given you the characteristics of me because you're in my likeness. I have given you the characteristics to conquer, to crush, to overcome, and to suppress. And then dominion, I have already given you the authorization, the command, control, and privilege, and most of all, the power. So we have to make sure we understand those five things is so crucial. If we keep that in our forefront, then when the enemy comes at us, then we could actually begin to operate in God. We can begin to speak the word on it because God has already, let me tell you this, God has already graced us for it. He already graced you for it. I know you're like, oh, you know, that's a lot. But listen, God has nothing but good for you. Amen? The problem is we must embrace it. A lot of times we look at the things of God and the things that God has for us, but we look at and we measure it in our own strength. We can't operate in God in our own strength. We got to relinquish ourselves because we can't do it. Listen, if I could have did it, I didn't need God. But I found out after falling over and over and over and over and over and over and over, listen, I needed some help. It's in his strength that we're made perfect. And the Bible says the footsteps of a good man is what? Ordered by the Lord. So we have to make sure that we are locked in, that we are in precise into God's word. And we have to understand that he already equipped us. He already gave us the grace for it. It's already done. You have to understand, one of the things you have to understand, a man is known by what he flees from, but by what he follows after, what he fights for, and what he is faithful to. There's never been a time in which there was not need or demand for a strong godly man to uphold what? Why are we godly men? What's the thing? We need to uphold the standards of God. We need to be the repairers of the breach. We have to make sure that we are not afraid to speak the word. We got to make sure that we're not ashamed to speak his word, to do his work. Because right now, I don't know about you, I don't know about Florida, but I know in Texas, right now, people are looking for answers. And this is not the time for you to be wavering. You have to speak. You got to put that on display. You have to make sure that you are being a great ambassador for God. One of the things that, since we're not called by ourselves, we're called by God, and we are godly men, we are ambassadors for him. We represent him. When they see us, they see him. You know, have you ever had someone tell you, it's something about what you say, it's something about you that is just attracted to it. It's the God in you that will attract people. And one of the things that you have to make sure you keep that on your forefront, because it's the spirit, man, it's the power down on the inside of you will attract people. You don't have to do it, but allow God to work his work in you. Amen? And so one of the things we have to understand, Satan is attempting to destroy the image and the identity of man in our homes. Listen, let's work. In our schools, and most of all in our churches, if we don't watch, listen, this is no spite to women. Listen, I love you. But we have to make sure, men, women is outpacing us in school and teachers in schools. I just came from Dallas and found out women is outpacing men in theology school, seminary, almost 2-1. We have to make sure we take our place. We must make sure that we are stay connected to God. And so that's why, let's deal with our text. Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul saw 2021 coming. And so he gave us a reference. And he says, first of all, he said, started out with, but godliness with contentment in verse 6 is a great gain. What he's saying is, you know, the Bible says, don't be anxious for nothing. But what it does say, be careful. That word careful means anxious. Don't be anxious for nothing. Don't be sporadic for nothing, because you have to be content where you at. Now, I'm not talking about that word contentment. Don't mean that you don't have no aspirations. You don't have no desires. You don't have no ambition. No, I'm not saying that. But you got to make sure that you're good where God got you at. And one of the things that in order to get to the next level in God, see, you got to understand God is a God of order. God is a God of discipline. You know, so when you at a certain place and you say, God, I've been here too long. Can I tell you a secret? It's not God. It's the man in the mirror. You have to make sure whatever place that you're at in God, whatever a place that God got you at, you have to make sure you bankrupt that level. In other words, you have to make sure that you cover every aspect. In order to go to the next step, the next dimension in God, you got to make sure you pass the test. And how do I pass the test? I'm not wavering. I know who I am in God. I know society is trying to give me subliminal messages and having two women on the commercials in the family. I know society is trying to throw me off with having the greatest image of a man. Y'all know the blue with the red cape, the greatest symbol of a man. Now they say that they finna incorporate him being a bisexual. I know we on Facebook Live, but it's all right. They're trying to change the image of a man. So we have to make sure, he says, be content, don't be anxious for nothing. Because when we get anxious, then we begin to do some crazy things. I'm saying it like that. He says, for in verse 7, he said, for we brought nothing into the world, and it's certain we can carry nothing out. So don't get wrapped up in materialistic things. I can stop right there. Verse 9, he says, but they that have to be rich fall into temptations and snare and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and prediction. And what that means is That's a total failure. That's a ruin. Y'all learned ruin last night. R-U-I-N. But when they talk about prediction, that means a total. Total destruction of man. So let's talk. As a man, one of the things that we are taught in society is we get measured by how much money we make. We get measured by the car that we drive. We get measured by, you know, the clothes that I'm wearing. You know, society put those demands on men. You know, we all strive to make the good money. We strive to drive the best of cars. Listen, I was taught on that. You're gonna drive the best. Even though I grew up in the ghetto of Chicago, but you better believe I had name brand on even in poverty, because I grew up in that mindset. And one of the things about it is we get wrapped up in the money. That the money, how much money we make becomes the totality of us. The amount of money that I make becomes who I am. The devil is a lie. The money that I make is not who I am. Because God forbid, listen, you got to understand it. Let's talk. God forbid, when you started out, it's a process. Now, I tell my sons all the time, it's a process in jobs. It's a process in schooling. You ain't going to start out as a baller. You ain't going to start out like, you know, listen, it's a process. But the problem is, everybody want to be a baller. Everybody want to be a shot caller. Everybody likes what they see on TV. Everybody likes what they see on the rapper. Everybody likes those things. But you got to know there's a process. Listen, God can bless you right now. He can bless you right now. He can blow your mind right now. But he's a great God. He's a caring God. If he bless you right now, he know mentally you can't handle the blessing. He know that you were splurging. He know that the blessings, listen, God don't want you, the blessings to take you out. He want the blessings. When it's time to bless you, it's going to be a blessing. You can handle it. Listen, I know that's unpopular right now. I know you want it now, but baby, you can't handle it right now. You got to endure the steps. And then you have to be content where you at. And you have to be a good steward. Oh, Lord. God is a God that he wants to see. You got to be a good steward. How many wants a financial blessing that's on the line right now? How many want to be? But watch this. Watch how God starts stuff. He starts out with, I got my deacon on the line, Deacon T. One of the things that he always say, I'm take this for him and let him know. One of the things he always say is, how you want God to bless you with the thousands when he can't even trust you with the hundreds? Y'all there? You know, you get $100, and you know, this thing called tithe. What he said is, hey, listen, all I want is 10 back. And $100 is nothing but $10. If you can't give 10, what makes you gonna be able to give 100? But watch this. What if you can't give 100? What makes you think you're gonna give 1,000? Listen, the more you make, the harder it is to give. I'm gonna tell you that right now. When I had to tithe, we sold our house in California. And I had to tithe. We bought that house for $133. And over 4 years, that house accumulated equity. When we sold it, it was like for $435. I had to tithe off of my increase. Listen, I was faithful in tithing on my paycheck. But when it came to be ready to tithe on some thousands, I was like, ooh, Lord. You, Jesus, Lord. But guess what? It teaches you discipline. It keeps you focused. Because if you tithe, you can save. And what he got, one thing I learned about God, I have 401ks, I have retirement funds and so forth. But when society changes and shifts, my 401ks shifts. My investments shift. But you know what don't shift? The equity that I have in heaven. The tithes that I have paid out. You know, that is just like a house. You paying your house note to have equity in it. I'm tithing because one, God says so. But I do know I get equity. I got equity in heaven. So when I can't, listen, when things not looking right, when my account is not right, I know I could call on the heavens and God can bless me. You gotta have equity. You gotta have something. Listen, let me teach you right here quick. You can't expect a ship if you don't release the ship. If you don't release that ship out, you can't expect that ship to come back in. And so here is Apostle Paul in verse 9. What he's saying is, as men, we get wrapped up in the pursuit of money, the pursuit of being the man, the pursuit of being the main man in our clique or in my crew. We get caught up in those things. And then things change. How many know life will throw you a blow? Life will throw you an uppercut. And when it throws you an uppercut, what happens when you get off with God, when you get off with his foundation, and you begin to start doing things on your own, then when it doesn't line up right, then you're all over the place because now you're trying to maintain it. Have anybody ever been in that place?
Say it, Pastor. I had to come off mute. Just say it. I'm going back.
Woo! You have to maintain it yourself. And then when you try to maintain, listen, I want everybody on this line to look at verse 10. Look at verse 10. 1 Timothy 6 and 10. And I want you to understand this. It says, for the love of money is the root of all evil. It says, the love of money is the root of all evil. The love of money is the root of all evil. He didn't say money was evil. The Bible says money is the defense. You know how it's going to be a defense? Because it'll push off Reliant. It'll push off GMAC. It'll protect you from your mortgage. It'll protect you. Money is a defense. And he wants you to have money. He wants the blessings. But you can't fall in love with the blessings. But you got to fall in love with the blesser. And so what he's saying is you are entangled day in, day out, trying to stay in that right place and be the trailblazer and be the man, that you're forgetting about the main man. Apostle Paul wants us to know, he says, when you get in those positions, when you, it's a famous poet, once said, famous poet by the name of Snoop Doggy Dogg, he said, I got my money on my mind and my mind on my money. What he's saying is, all it is everything is about the money. But Apostle Paul says, if you are in that posture, you will, I'm afraid to tell you that you will be erred and be, what he says, you'll be erred from the faith, because you will slowly by slowly remove yourself. You will remove God out of the equation, because you on that money chase, you on that pursuit. You running out.
Preaching real good, overseer. You preaching real good. I just had to chime in another time. Okay, I'm back up.
Amen. You on that pursuit. So this is the thing that society is using against us. You know, they show you the rappers with the chains, the stack of money. They show you all the lavish things. They show you the eye candy. But I came to tell you, don't go for the eye candy. You stay within God, because he have made a covenant with you. He have given you a promise that will outlast. He will outlast a gold chain. God is better than a gold chain. God is better than a stack. Matter of fact, he'll even give you a card. He'll give you a metal card. He'll give you he will change your status just like that, but you got to trust him. But one of the things we have to understand is God made the promise. He gave us the covenant. Those five things that he wants us to do, because that is power. But in the contract, there was a contention in the contract. And that was, if you read the fine line, you had to be faithful and you had to be obedient to his word. All those things, those blessings that he has for you, everything that he has for you, there is a criteria, there's a standard. You know, God, listen, what he's saying is, you have to be obedient. And then here, I love this. Apostle Paul says, he says, in verse 11 says, O thou, O man of God, flee these things. Flee that way of thinking. Flee that, those bodies, flee it. He says, and then follow after righteousness. Follow after godliness. Follow after faith, follow after love, patience, and meekness. Because in those things is value. In those things is a life. In those things is strength. In those things is posterity. In those things is prosperity. And then it goes into verse 12. He says, fight the good fight of faith. Godly men has to have the ability to fight. You cannot succumb. You cannot allow the enemy to take you out. You gotta know this. Let me just put this out there. You know, listen, I'm in Texas, y'all in Florida. You know, listen, I don't know how many people I got from Miami on here, but watch this. What he's saying is, I ain't telling you going to fight your brother. I definitely ain't saying you're going to fight your sister. What I'm saying is, you got to be able to fight the enemy. You got to fight principalities. You got to fight him. You got to fight, he said, with faith. One, you got to have faith in God. You got to have faith in God. And you got to fight it with the good, he said, a good fight of faith. And he says, to hold on to eternal life. How many know to get to heaven, you got to fight? It's a fight to get there. It's a fight to make sure, because every day there's something. So that's why the Bible says you got to renew your mind daily. You got to prepare yourself daily. You got to make sure you have the word in you. You got to make sure, because the word will be your defense, but also the word is a sluggard, a two-edged sword. It will cut asunder everything that comes before you. But watch this. I love the way Apostle Paul, I love the way he puts you as a godly man. What he's saying is, because he's now, he ain't talking about men. He have made a separation. He says, oh, godly men. So now he's talking to the church. He's talking to the men of the church. He says, godly man. I love the way he changed the narrative. And he exhorts him to do the part of a soldier. You know, we always say we're in the army of the Lord. But he puts them as part of a soldier. Fight the good fight of faith. Like I said, those that get to heaven must fight their way there. So watch this. Okay, here we go. There must be a conflict with corruption and temptation and the opposition of the powers of darkness. There must be a conflict. I ain't talking to men now. I'm talking to godly men. There must be a conflict between you and corruption and temptations and oppositions of powers of darkness. There comes a time when you have to make a decision. There comes a time when God say, now listen, you gotta put a line right here. Who you with? You rolling with me? You rolling with me or you rolling with Rush? No, we rolling with God. Because watch this. When he's saying that fight, it's gonna take then the godly men. It's gonna take us praying. It's gonna take you fasting. It's gonna take you restoring your brethren. That's when we get endowed with power. And when God's talking about power, he comes from the Greek root, Hebrew power for dunamis. That means total power. And God wants to make sure that we are successful. Why? Because he wants us. What's the five things? He wants us to be fruitful, multiply, replenish, subdue, and have dominion. Those things is what we're fighting for. And we're fighting for our next generation. We're fighting for the kingdom. Amen? It's up to us. Now this is a personal appeal. It's up to us, brethren, to help raise up the younger generation. You know, and I'm trying to look. I don't got my glasses. I can't see. But it's up to us to raise the next generation. Because as we see, they're taking a lot out of schools. They're taking a lot out of the books, even with some of the Bibles. They're taking some passages out, you know, the NIV and so forth. So it's up to us to hold the standard. Time out. If you are a godly man, it's time out for the foolishness. It's time to be sober. Sober up. It's time to get to work. And we work, it's time to fight. And we're gonna fight for this thing. And what? we're going to fight the good fight of faith. And God, and if we do that, God will bless. God will open up doors. God will elevate. Whatever desires of your heart, he says, seek ye the kingdom first. It's all about the kingdom. Everything else is the benefits of being within God. I've been there not having enough. I've been there, in the struggle. But I'm here to tell you, he is a rewarder. If you stay faithful to him, he definitely be faithful to you. Amen? And so I want to make sure that touch on one thing also, that as men of God, we have to make sure that we're in unprecedented times. Things is not the norm anymore. So it is essential that we pray together. I salute Apostle. You know, you got the Zoom, you got technology, you got all this. You have to embrace it right now. And we got to move forward. And I heard her say that we grew in the pandemic. Through the grace of God, you will grow if you stay under his hedge of protection. If you stay connected to him, if you stay plugged in, God got you. And as long as he got you, and as long as you stay obedient, as long as you stay submitted unto him, then, and you resemble him, and you be a great ambassador for him, listen, God will blow your mind. I promise you that. So I am ecstatic. Thank you so much for allowing me to speak to you guys, the men, to empower you, a word. Don't get discouraged. Don't get caught up into what you see. But I need you to see things through the Spirit. To know, I'm going to tell you a secret. I messed around and read the end of the book, and I found out we win. One thing about God, he'll show you the light at the end of the tunnel. But he don't tell you what you're going to go through in the tunnel. So you have to make sure that I can tell you, he'll go through the tunnel with you. Don't be afraid. We was talking last night, and one of the things that was said, God will always meet you at the place where there is fear. He will always meet you there. So don't be afraid. Just listen, God got you. Because you are a powerful, godly man. Come on, put those hands together and celebrate them. Listen, one of the things that I want to thank you guys for allowing me to speak. And also, we have to make sure, one of the things that I have learned over time, when God speaks and when God partakes, and I have learned that you have to put a seed on that word. You have to put a seed on that expectation. Amen? You have to make sure that you bless the word, because God didn't even have to do it. God didn't even have to sin. But because he did, he's present and he is a rewarder. Listen, he'll be a sower to the sower. He'll give seed to the sower. And so one of the things on that is the most important part about that, you got to be found to be a sower. Every time when I'm challenged in sowing, God has always provided. But there was a step. Let me just one thing. when I say you have to bankrupt levels, one of the things that I saw that my wife do, Apostle Ty, for those of you that know her or don't know her, one thing is that she would just, you know how you're trying to bankrupt levels. You're trying to go and please. This was her thing. So I remember, you know, I was buying her Coach purses. I was buying her, you know, the Dooney Burks and all that stuff and whatever. But at one time she had got a Louis Vuitton purse. And then she made a demand. She says, I'm going, all I want from God, because I'm putting a demand on God, is I want, you know, the higher, you know, the more, the Louis, whatever.
Yeah.
But in order for that to happen, this is the thing that blew my mind. We had church, and I saw her at the house. I thought she was just organizing her closet. But she came to church, we go at separate times, but I saw all those bags that I had bought her, all those Coach bags, all those Dooney Burke bags, all that stuff. And I saw her begin to give it out to the congregation. Now listen, I'm a brother. I'm like, wait a minute. I just gave you that. Yeah, I just, what's going on? I was like, what? What she was doing? She was putting a demand on God. What she was doing? She was bankrupting. What she was saying is, I'm bankrupting this level. And no shade, wherever you at. But when it's time for you to go to the next step, next elevation, sometimes, I mean, I say you got to bankrupt, listen, and you got to eliminate every excuse, because it's natural for us to go back to it. If I have it available, well, I'm just going to use this person. No, she gave it away. She got rid of everything. And so she, all I got is this one Louis purse. And I'm going to carry this one Louis purse until God bless. And I wasn't where I'm at now. I couldn't, we wasn't there. This was a God thing. This was a faith thing. And I'm here to tell you, God blessed her. And I'm like, what? He blessed her. God will meet you at your level of faith. Give God an arena. A lot of times when we get to the giving part, this is the time when God is measuring. This is the God is going to be a test of faith. So don't hold that seed. Let that seed go. Because money is the currency. It has to be on the go. Amen? If you are paying the cash out, it will be money sign Kingdom 103. Money sign Kingdom 103. I think they might have something in the chat room. But we have to be a blessing. And I thank you guys. Come on, put your hands together. And I appreciate you. Receive Apostle Carol Baker.
Woo! Wow! Woo! Lord, have mercy. Overseer, overseer. Powerful word. I tell y'all guys is rumbling in this earth realm. Awesome. Y'all thank God for the man of God in that word. Amen. Hallelujah. And as y'all preparing to give, we do have a square link as well in the comment section. Amen. But Pastor, I want you to just pray for all the men before we go any further, okay? As they prepare to give all these thousands of dollars. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Let's bless. Oh, Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for your men right now, Lord. We thank you for the leaders right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. We thank you for the head of the households right now, Lord. Touch their heart and mind, Lord. Give them the strength to endure right now, Lord. We declare that they will not give up. They will not tap out. They will not they will be able to finish the race right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Lord, you have assured us with that when the enemy comes in like a flood, that, Lord God, you will lift up a standard against it. So we are assured that the enemy will never overtake us. As long as we in your word, as long as we in your purpose and your destiny right now, Lord. And Lord, we thank you and we praise you, Jesus, Lord. Cover everyone under your blood right now. And Lord, touch the mind, strengthen right now in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I just thank God for such an awesome word. Amen. Just awesome. It's time to fight. I'm not going to say much on it. I'm just going to, and when you says money just doesn't define you, but some stood out. You said so much. When you say men are more than gold chains and new cars and that image, you know, and you gave us that, they had to be fruitful, multiply, replenish, subdue, and have dominion. Pastor Cole was saying the same thing on last night. I tell you, it is awesome. Awesome word. I wanted to just scream, but you know, I know we labbing and everything, you know, I want to run around and all kind of stuff. Y'all guys are thebomb.com. I'm just so excited. And I believe the men of God on here and those that are listening to us on live streaming, I believe that you all was empowered tonight. God has did something great in your life. Amen. We're not going to leave this place without sowing into this awesome word. Amen. Like Pastor says, so much going on out there around us, but it's time to fight. It's just time to fight. Amen. And so it come to a time you got to bankrupt some places. And I know how that is. Amen. Where you just decide, I'm not giving $100 no more. I'm giving two. I'm giving five. I'm just not doing it like that no more. Amen. You have to make up in your mind. Awesome. I just thank God for you, Pastor Larry, coming all the way from Houston, Texas with a powerful word. Did y'all enjoy it with a thumbs up? All right. All right. Amen. 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 I am I'm just elated on what God is doing. When I asked these guys, they were just so into coming for me, and I thank God for them. I just thank God for you all. Listen, I'm gonna get, I don't see him. But anyway, Pastor Snow, would you like to say something right quick?
Good to see you, Pastor Watts. We love you. Kingdom Dominion Assembly, Jacksonville, Florida. Yes, Lord, we love you. We thank you for the clarity, the revelation of the word. I tell you what, I got me some great notes to carry me to the next level. God bless you and Apostle Watts.
Amen, amen, amen. Pastor Rico, are you here? Bless the Lord. Brother Monty.
Amen.
There's Pastor Rico. Go ahead, Brother Ronnie, just quickly. These are the guys that show our men where our men are.
Amen. Bless the Lord. Like Apostle say, I'm elated. I just bless God and I give honor to God, to you, Apostle, and to the psalmist and Pastor Larry Watts. I bless God for you coming through tonight. Most definitely empowered me to go to the next level and to vision in and just have that tunnel vision to do those five things you said. And then I'm in a place like this, a little small test. I'm in a place right now to where, you know, I lost my job. I didn't necessarily lose it, but I got in a very bad car accident to where, you know, I can still go to work, but it'd be hard on my body. But I'm not going to go back, and I'm in a place right now to where I'm like, man, I need some money, man. I'm trusting in God. But you zoom my focus in on you said fall in love with the blesser, not the blessing. And you say we be obedient and stay faithful. That's all of that's gonna happen. So I bless God for you just helping me to just zoom my focus in on what I need to do and focus on fighting as being a godly man. God bless you, man of God.
Amen, amen, amen. Pastor Rico.
Amen, amen. Blessing, Pastor Watts. It was a powerful word. I heard a lot of it. I've been getting a lot of calls from my job. I'm on call. But the word was on time. It was powerful. It ignited me. I'm like Monty said, it has, and Pastor Snow said, it pushed me to my next place. And I just thank God for you, just for just coming in and letting God use you. I mean, the word was on time. I needed it. I needed every word of it. I bless the Lord for you. Keep doing what you're doing, man of God. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just awesome. Amen. I see Pastor Cole is with us tonight. Amen. Shout out, Pastor Cole. Blessings to you. Amen. I hear that Apostle Ty was on our live. God bless you, Apostle Ty. You know we love you. Amen. From the state of Florida. Thank God for you, Elder Clyde Douglas. Y'all come on, give it up for Elder Clyde. Awesome. Ooh, Elder Clyde will be back with us tomorrow night, and I'm going to give him some room to say something tomorrow night. I just thank God for everybody. Pastor Brittany, are you available? Amen. I just thank God for all of you great guys. Amen. And we love you. And Pastor Larry, you could come to Florida anytime. Amen. This is just not for just on Zoom, y'all. When we're going to do it a bigger and a greater way. We're going to do it a bigger and a greater way one day, you know, but this is great. And I had to step out of my comfort zone. I had to bankrupt one area and just step out and do something I had never done before. And guess what? I ain't scared. It just pushed me and made me learn so much. Amen. And I'm going to tell Apostle Ty, let me tell you, just a quite quick little testimony about Apostle Ty. Now, and I believe every word he said about it. She has some sunglasses that I loved. And so I was, you know, I like to wear my sunglasses. You know what I'm saying? And they be about like 10,000. Sometimes they be about like 25. And I be like, woo, these $25, $30. I said, I love them sunglasses. Let me put them on. I put them sunglasses on. I saw the world totally different. I said, what kind of sunglasses is these? And I believe she told me that it was Gucci. I said, whoa. I said, Lord have mercy. I got the bankrupts this here dollar store, these here, these Walmart glasses and get me some Gucci's. I went in the store with her when I was in Texas and we went in this fabulous shoe store. And it's the truth. And we went in and she went in and the man, the salesman say, how are you, Miss Watts? And gave us some water, and I said, this the way I got to live. You knew her by, I'm talking about in a big mall. Y'all ain't feeling me. When I came back from Houston, I was like, wow, I can walk on water. Let me go. And now I'm finna, that's one of my purses I want, Pastor. That one, what you just said, I want one of them. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna go get me one too. Amen. What's the name of that purse I want, Brittany? Louis Vuitton. Amen. So I get rid of all the rest of them. I have to go get me a Louis. Woo! I'm so excited. I might go buy me a Louis tomorrow. It ain't always been like that now. It happened. Amen. You got to fake it till you make it. You just got to go through your process. Is that right? Amen. Pastor Brittany, say something right quick to the men of God.
Amen. Well, first I want to apologize to everybody. I did have to work tonight, so I do apologize for my absence, but I was able to still hear the word. So Overseer Watts, powerful word, powerful. It's just been powerful this last two nights. So And Apostle, I am just so proud of you. I remember when we first had to get on Zoom, you did not want to do this. And now you hosting a whole conference. God have a way of stretching us. So Apostle, I'm proud of you, girl. Yes. But to the men of God, to the men of God at KDA, I love you guys. I respect you guys. And I'm proud of y'all as well. So I pray everybody have a blessed night, and I'm looking forward to the duration of this conference. Amen. Blessings.
Amen. And we just thank the Lord for everybody. Amen. And so tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, we'll be here again. And what I love about Overseer Watts, you know, we are an hour ahead of him. So he, you know, behind us. And tomorrow night, Bishop is an hour behind us as well. And but we are here and we are going to have a good time. And we know that Ella Clyde going to bring it again tomorrow night. Amen. And I want to see the men from KDA right after we go off live. Amen. Thank everybody from all over the everywhere, from Kenya, Africa, Nigeria, Africa, Texas, Dallas, Texas, Houston, Texas, Florida, all over the land. I thank you so much for tuning in to this great, great opportunity. Until tomorrow night, you be blessed and let the Lord bless you. And men of God all over the world, it's time to fight. Amen. You more than what the world try to make you look like, and you more than what the enemy is trying to attempt to do to you. You are the great and awesome men of God. Till tomorrow night. Love y'all. Y'all be blessed. Bye.